America's Got Talent. And who are you?
My name is Cam Bertrand. I'm a stand-up comedian from Tampa, Florida.
But you don't sound like you're from Tampa, Florida.
My accent's all over the place. Through the set, you'll hear it fluctuate. It's weird. Public school and, I don't know, I'm weird.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, we did it.
So you said you are a stand-up comedian.
Yes, I am.
Yes.
I've been doing stand-up for about 8 years now.
And how did you get into that?
When I was a kid, I would stay up far past my bedtime, and I would watch more comedy than a kid probably should. It's actually how I first saw Howie. Yeah.
Also, that was a long, long time ago.
Cam, good luck to you.
Thank you. I actually just turned 27. I celebrated my birthday a couple weeks ago. Yeah, it's weird turning 27 because I feel like I'm getting older, but my face isn't. Yeah, it's strange. Like, it's tough having a baby face, you know, because, like, all I wanted to do for my birthday was to celebrate by getting a nice bottle of wine, you know, like an adult. But when I went to the store, I picked out the bottle I wanted. I went to the counter. I put it on the counter, as you do for purchases, right? And the lady looked at me. She looked at the bottle. She looked back at me, and she went, ha! No! That was it. That was the whole transaction. That's not protocol. You don't just get to go, no. Right? I was upset. I wasn't mad that she thought I was underaged. I get it. I look 17 at best. I wasn't mad she thought I was young. But I was upset that she thought an underaged person would be buying wine. Right? Like, I don't understand. In what world do you live in, Rebecca? Where some 17-year-old dude is showing up to this house party like, poof. Y'all not gonna believe this. I got Pinot Grigio! Yeah, got that Grigio! Let's do shots of Chardonnay. Let's start a book club! Yeah. That's never happened, right? You don't know a 17-year-old that owns a corkscrew. That's weird, all right? Not one time in your entire life can you tell me a time where you've seen a 17-year-old dude be like, This Merlot pairs so well with the Doritos Locos Taco.
Oh, that's good.
It is just something about Zinfandels in a Hot Pocket that is to die for. I think there's two things alcohol-wise we should stop IDing for altogether, right? Wine and bourbon. Yeah, because no matter how old you are, if you're drinking them, you've earned it. Think about it. If you're drinking wine, clearly you have a lot of emotions and you're going through some things. And if you're drinking bourbon, you have no emotions. You've been through some things. Thank you, guys. It's been my time.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. The stage is yours.
Come on and cry.
Well, I wasn't expecting that.
I know what you're all thinking. The Terminator let himself go a bit. I'm here to shine and do things my way.
I love it. Wow.
And here we have the lesser spotted, majestic Simon Cowell. This creature lives an honest and basic existence and can often be seen jet-skiing off the coast of Barbados with one simple thought running through its mind.
Ah, the delicious Amanda Holden! do you stay looking so young? David Walliams, let me show you my world-famous mind-reading trick. I see a vision of Simon Cowell. Mission. I think you'll agree.
I did it. I mean, it was extraordinary. One incredible surprise after another. I was wildly entertained from start to finish. It was brilliant.
Amanda?
Brilliantly innovative, very funny. I mean, I didn't know robots had a sense of humour.
Simon?
It was absolutely amazing. Yeah. I mean, incredible. Yeah. Eric's gonna go crazy.
So funny, so cheeky. Can't wait to see what you do again. So I'm gonna say yes.
I am saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
You will be back for your
Titan will be back.
I said that.
Hi, everybody.
Welcome.
Good evening or afternoon. I have no idea.
Good evening. Tell us your name.
I'm Jackie Fabulous.
And where are you from, Jackie?
I'm from the Bronx. I'm from Bronx, New York.
Boogie down. And what do you do for a living?
I'm a full-time touring stand-up comic, yes.
Oh, wow.
So what got you into comedy?
You know, I went to law school. I'm a lawyer. Oh. I know, right? Total disappointment. I had to quit my lawyer job because I got fired. So it made it awkward being there every day, you know what I mean?
So when you got fired, were your parents supportive?
No.
Oh, no.
They don't understand what I'm doing. They don't get it. They don't understand who leaves being a lawyer to be a stand-up comic. They're like, why are you doing this to your life?
I don't want to wait any longer. Take it away, Jackie.
All righty. My Jamaican mother wants me to lose weight, but she doesn't know how to tell me. She's in New York. She comes to L.A. You know how you see your parents, you become a child again? I'm like, oh, my God, Mommy! She's like, Jacqueline, Lord have mercy, you're fat. Jesus, you are fat. What are you eating, people? I don't like weight loss TV shows. If you love that show, The Biggest Loser, you and I can't be friends. You know how that show works? If somebody's overweight, you lock them on an island, and they have to work out 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, and oh yeah, we're gonna make you wear a small spandex bra and baby panties and weigh you on a scale and for cattle on national TV. Wouldn't you lose weight? Who's losing these contests? You want to impress me, get a bunch of fatties and lock them in a donut shop. The first one to not go into a diabetic coma wins. That's the show I would support.
She's getting them. She's winning them over.
I don't like Facebook. It's too much work for me now. It's cool till you find that friend from too far back. You know how they find you? They're like, oh my God, I found you. What have you been doing? I'm like, last time I saw you, I learned how to read, learned how to write. Puberty was wrong. Who's this? And they send you news you don't need. Did you hear Sister Mary Ellen passed away? I'm like, when you and I were 8, she was 88. She a wizard? Is she a warlock? I hope she's dead. Should've been dead 30 years ago. And all done. Thank all you. Right. Thank you.
Hello?
Hello?
You look quite scary. Okay, sir, what is your name, please?
I'm Lioz.
Where are you from originally?
Israel.
What is it that you're doing today?
I'm a mentalist.
You're a mentalist?
I can read people's minds.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I've seen this guy before in America.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Why are you not doing?
Good evening.
Only you.
Is it you not doing
it? I did it.
You did it.
Huh? I said it.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I need a volunteer. You. Come up on stage. What's your name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yes.
Tell the truth. Is that you?
Yes.
Here I have two boxes. I want you to choose one of the boxes. Now, turn around back to back. I want you to open the box. Inside, you will find plastic bags with different colors. Mm-hmm. I want you to think at one of the colors and take it out. Now, put the box on the floor. Open the plastic bag with two ends and think on the color. Now, I want you to count to 10 slowly, and both of us will turn to the audience at the same time. Mm-hmm. Start counting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Well, wait, start from the beginning.
1, 2, 3.
Slowly.
1, 2.
Yeah, now it's good.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Thank you. It's souvenir.
Thank you.
But wait.
Oh.
No, I took something from you. You didn't even notice. Chegwood, what did I take from you? I took something from you. You're missing something. Here is your watch!
Thank you. Oh, it's good.
And you? I took something from you too. Good, what did I take from you? Here is your wallet! And you? No, your wallet! What's inside? Your wallet!
From laughing.
David, what did you think?
Well, I think you're an absolute comedy genius. It was brilliant.
It's not comedy.
Well, then I think you're screwed, because you're the world's worst mentalist.
It was genius. It was just brilliant. You had us in the palm of your hands. You have an incredible presence about you, and it was hilariously funny.
Oh, it's magic.
I think the act is very, very funny, and I would love to see you go a long way.
I now understand that this guy is a genius. So I have to start this with a yes.
It's a yes for me.
It's a yes for me.
Four yeses.
Thank you all. I love you, Britain. Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Samuel J. Comro. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing comedy for 10 years now.
Do you do it full-time?
Yeah, do it full-time.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No, I have Tourette's syndrome, so I twitch a lot. I blink real fast. My head flops around. If you see that, it's kind of cute.
It is.
Thank you.
What does this mean to you?
coming to AGT now?
This means everything. I've worked my entire life for a moment like this. They don't come very often. I'm really grateful. I just had a baby girl, and this is a beautiful opportunity.
Wow. And your family's all supportive of this career?
Yes, since I started, they've been 100% behind me, so I'm very thankful.
All right. Well, you know what? It's scary enough doing whatever you do to hit that X, and I just want the best for you. I really do.
Thanks so much.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So like I said, I have Tourette syndrome. It's why my head flops around. I blink real fast. It's weird. It always looks like I'm trying to tell you a secret. This twitch gets me in trouble. My roommate came home from work. I was like, dude, our neighbor died. He said, did you kill him? I was like, nah. Yo, this is a true story. When I was 10 years old, my parents sent me to Tourette's camp. Yeah, that's where the joke should end. It's a real place, and I didn't realize it till this moment, but I found out that when other people twitch, it makes me twitch more. So on the first day, they put us in a circle with 100 kids. Oh, no. The kid next to me did a shoulder roll. And my Tourette saw that and took that as a challenge. And I threw him a head flop. The girl next to him did a full body twitch, and everybody saw that, and all hell broke loose.
That is funny.
Kids were rolling on the ground. I was in the corner like, why'd they send us here? Our parents were on top of a hill like, oh, they're breakdancing. I'm Samuel J. Conroe. Thank you.
Hello there.
Oh, hello. Are you all right?
Yeah.
Good, how are you?
How's your dog?
He's gorgeous.
He's quite boring, though, isn't he?
No, he's mental.
Come on, Max. Come on. So...
No, I remember him being cute but boring.
No, that's David's dog. David's dog literally smokes a pipe, I reckon.
Yeah.
They're all ready for you. Let's
good boy, Max. Thank you.
Oh! It's a Yorkshire Terrier.
Didn't like me, did he? It's his problem.
Hi, what's your name?
Dave.
Dave, and who have you got in your arms, Dave?
Max the dog. He's eyeballing me, isn't he? Yeah. Eh?
Do you have a day job?
I'm getting a van driving job in 2 weeks' time.
Did you ever see Pudsey, who won the show?
Absolutely, Simon.
I mean,
yes.
Are you and Max as good as that?
I reckon me and Max are just as good as that, yes.
Oh, look at him.
What a cutie.
He's not so cute, believe me.
And how long have you been preparing for this?
5 years, Simon.
Oh, wow. Okay, well, good luck.
Good luck. Thank you. Oh, he's so cute.
He's so cute.
Come here, Max.
And it's cold, please.
Fine. What's his problem with me? Yeah, come here. What? I love dogs.
Is he gone?
Max, look! What's the matter? All right, okay! He's getting shot, please!
There you are. Good boy. Are we friends now? There we are. Come on. Good boy. Good boy.
What's his problem?
Come here.
I like the act. Dog has good instincts.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Apart from chasing Ant, I just really would love to know what else Max was going to do.
He should have done some singing.
Seriously? Always wanted to find a dog that could sing.
It's just brilliant it all went to plan. I'm sorry, it's enough.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. I'm excited to be here. I'm so happy to be back. I'm back with my son. My son is with me. He is officially 1 year old now. And he's saying words, which I know he's gonna be insulting me any minute now. Because kids don't have a filter until you as the grown-up put it in. They just say whatever comes to their mind. Have you ever been insulted by a kid? It legit hurts your feelings, doesn't it? Because they'll just walk right up to you and they'll be like, you're ugly, and then walk away. And you're left standing there as the grown-up like, isn't he adorable? But when you think about it, that kid isn't trying to mess with you. Like, if that kid said you're ugly, it's because he genuinely thinks you're ugly. But like, so ugly he had to stop what he was doing and inform you of the situation. Like, right? Like, he's doing something and he looked up like, oh God, what is that? No, put the Legos away. Before having a baby, the most stressful thing I did was plan my wedding. Yeah, it was stressful from the start. One of my girlfriends, when she found out I was getting married, she said, so are you gonna lose weight for your wedding? No, I know. I was like, no, but I'm going to lose girlfriends. Let them know. I wasn't going to torture myself for my wedding. No, I wore Spanx like a grown-up. That's right. Spanx are amazing, right? They are, until you got to take them off. That's the sad part. You put them on, you feel invincible, right? Then the end of the night comes and it's like, wah, wah, wah. All you have to show for your hard work is a roadmap of pain embedded into your skin. You touch it, it's like Braille. It's like, help me. I love it when I can see women laughing at that know exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, it's even better when they're sitting next to a woman that has no idea what I'm talking about. Because she looks horrified. I was at a show and I was talking about Spanx and this woman up front said, that sounds awful. Why don't you just diet and exercise? I was like, that sounds awful. My thing's way better. You guys have been great, thank you, that's my time.
Dear 25, it 48 a.m. and the new celebrity housemates have arrived by Big Brother Carl.
Oh, did somebody mention Carl? Oh, yeah. Oh, hello, Simon. Or can I call you Daddy?
8:49 a.m. The housemates are having donuts for breakfast.
And it's Emily making donuts.
Donuts. Is there anything they can't do? Marge!
Oh, Homer, what are you talking about? Are you talking about donuts again, homie? Homie!
We'll be back after the break.
I've had an accident. And I think I'm entitled to some compensation.
9:49 a.m. Time to find out if he's got the X Factor.
You look like a pop star. You sound like a pop star. I'm putting you through. But Gary, Sharon, Nicole, we need to find out the thoughts of one final judge, Simon.
Okay, let me stop you there.
What's that?
I don't know.
Is that chicken?
Is it a chicken?
It is a chicken.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, what are your names?
Sehi.
I'm Shannon.
And who are you here with today?
Joku.
Tofu?
No, Joku. Joku.
What is Joku going to do?
Nope, got it.
She's going to play the keyboard, and she'll play America the Beautiful.
Are you serious?
Yes.
She plays the piano.
She does. She's going to play that keyboard right there.
No, she's not.
She picked it up very quickly. She's very intelligent.
Amazing. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
I can't wait to see that.
Do it. Chicken's going to play the piano. Good luck, baby. Do your thing.
Wait a minute.
No way. No!
That is crazy. I do. I mean, I've never seen that
of the Palladium Theatre. I invite you to stand and welcome Her Majesty the Queen.
The Queen? What? That's why there's a throne.
That's right, Mr. Cowell. The boss is finally here. It's so good to see a member of the royal family sitting next to Simon. It's lovely to see you, Camilla. Yes. It is rare indeed for the sovereign to appear on such an insignificant occasion. But as I look down on you all, I am happy to patronize you. Queens have always patronized the arts, and the arts have relied upon the support of queens. And it is with regret, ladies and gentlemen, I have noted that recently Britain's Got Talent has suffered enormously. There have been far too many below average variety acts, and I'm not referring to Alicia Dixon. I beg your pardon. I'm sure you all agree that plastic is the modern scourge on the face of this planet. Of all the men and women of these islands, no greater innovation has been made than by our judging panel, who have stored a great amount of plastic in their faces.
Ooh, cutting!
That direction.
For their services to the entertainment industry, and Dick, as well as David Williams, have been awarded OBEs. Simon, there is only one thing standing between you and the knighthood, and that's the golden buzzer. I have much pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, in declaring the search for talent in Great Britain officially open.
What a treat!
Hello! Welcome.
Sorry, we do not talk. But we will be glad to give you answers only after you can ask the question according to the answer.
Okay, well, let's start with your name, please.
We are the Demented Brothers.
And where are you from?
We are going to do magic.
Okay, what would it mean to you to win? What would you do with $1 million?
Yes.
Okay, what's your ultimate dream? This is really important, this question.
Thank you for your questions. Now it's showtime. You will love it, Simon.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's start with hello.
Hello. I am Viggo. I'm from Norway, but I live in the UK now.
Good.
Norway is very boring.
And what's your last name?
Venn. Yeah, like the diagram.
You know? Venn diagram, that's right.
Viggo, why are you here?
I'm here because I want to become a British comedian.
Okay, right, no more questions. Good luck.
Thank you. Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good.
Oh.
Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Honestly?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this song so
stupidity to such a level that was just, it was killing me.
Oh, I thought you were going to do stand-up comedy.
Yeah, but it's a bit difficult with the language for me.
I have no idea what's going on right now, but it was really annoying, it was stupid, none of it was very good. Let's just go to the yes and no bit. Bruno.
Is a yes for me?
Oh, definitely yes.
Look, you know what? I like the music, but it is what it is, which is... the most stupid act we've had this year.
I think this feels very much Britain's Got Talent-y. So I'm going to say yes. We've got through to the next round.
What is your name?
I'm Mike E. Winfield.
Mikey, what is your age?
Oh, so I'm like 20s to like 30s and stuff, you know, all right.
Where are you from?
I'm originally from Baltimore. I did adequate time in Sacramento, a lot of love.
What do you do?
You know what? I tell jokes, you know?
How long you been doing this?
Over 15 years.
So do you even remember the first time you step on a stage?
Oh my gosh, do I remember? Yeah, it was a Tuesday night open mic. And I get on stage with bright lights and arms crossed, and now they're all staring at me, and I just kind of freeze. So the fact that I came back, that means there's something wrong with me.
Okay, so show us what is wrong with you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, thank you. I love older moms. Like, I like it when her kids just moved out. I can set up my computer in the extra bedroom, you know? I got married to an older woman. I got a stepson. It's cool being a parent to a kid that's close to your age. I call him Stepman. He drove me here. That's my step homeboy, man. And it's a weird dynamic if you see it. He's like 6'2 with chest hair. I don't have any, you know? Teenage boys can be gross. You know when they're doing inappropriate stuff on their laptop, because when you walk in on them, they'll slam it down really fast and then ask you some irrelevant question. I walk in on Stepman, he's like, who's running for Congress? I'm like, oh. Like, Stepman. I quit my job at the grocery store. Stepman's like, what are we gonna do for money, Step Mike? I'm like, hey, don't worry about it, okay? And I worked at this grocery store for a lot of hateful years. Why is it when you hate your job, they won't fire you? And now look, I worked in the worst department at the grocery store, not the meat, not produce, not the freezer. I worked in the steel department. You familiar with the steel department, right? Self-checkout lane? I got paid to watch people steal all day. And people think you stupid. Like, you know when they gonna rob you when they bringing up their stuff, they always gotta look back up at you. They're like, boop, boop. This one dude tried to humiliate me. Like, I knew he was gonna rob us because I'm looking at him. He's looking at me. I'm like, just steal it. He tries to play me in front of the entire store while he's ringing his stuff up. He makes the beat noise with his mouth. He didn't even do it right. Like, you gotta act this out, go all in, raise your pitch at least. He's like, bleh. Like, the produce is not even supposed to make a sound. You're beeping unbeepable stuff. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Look at these people.
Oh, they're doing it all. Look at this. Wow. Thank you so much.
I mean, I don't think there's anything else to say. They love you.
Oh,
I love you.
Thank you.
It's amazing. Your energy, your smile. I loved it.
Oh, thank you.
Howie.
Everything you say is memorable, is authentic. Your smile, your persona. You're great.
Wow.
Wow, I appreciate it.
Heidi!
You are fantastic. And then there's this face.
Thank you.
Look at his face. That face is just so cute.
Why don't you mention his face?
Isn't his face so cute? Yeah.
Well, you have a real star quality about you,
he
Mike.
He does.
You really do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
We could never do this show without an audience, particularly with an act like yourself, and this audience loved you. I mean, you could tell that.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you all. I appreciate you.
And Mike, look, we always say an audition on this show, 2 minutes literally can change your life. Maybe this is one of those auditions. I've got a good feeling about you.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to start voting. Simon.
Yes.
Me, yes.
Yes.
Four yeses.
Thank you.
Yeah, we love Mikey.
Very good.
Yeah, that kid's a star.
I mean, I think he's one of my favorite comedians that I've seen in these three seasons.
I think so. So I'll just start then.
To start.
Do you think it'll be any good? No.
Hello! My name's Graham, and it's now time for some magic. And for my magic tonight, I'm going to need a glamorous assistant. Amanda, could you join me on the stage? Let's have a big cheer for Amanda, everybody!
Woo! That big enough for you?
Now, what we're going to do tonight is me and Amanda are going to do some magic. First of all, I'm going to start with a simple magic trick. So I've got some cards here tonight. I've got a birthday card. I've got a wedding card. I've got a get well soon card. I've got welcome to your new home and happy birthday, generic pink. So I'm going to place the cards face down because that's what all the magicians do. What one do you want to go for, Amanda?
This one.
That one. Have a look, Amanda. Lovely. And I will now predict what card Amanda has picked. Amanda.
Yeah?
I've forgotten what one it was now. Now, Amanda, I've written a word in the piece of paper just here. Do you know what the word says?
No.
No, that's correct. No. And now I have two cups and a bottle of water. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. There's water going in that one. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. A little bit more in that one. A little bit more in that one. And now, before your very eyes, me and Magic Amanda will make the water disappear. Amanda, if you put the cup on your head like that, Amanda, could you hold that with one hand for me? Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. So we're going to do the magic water dance. And ladies and gentlemen, the magic water dance will make the water disappear. Let's do this. Yeah. Right. Okay, hold the dance first. You go right foot, left foot, left foot. You turn around, you face the back, you bend your knees three times, and then you wiggle your bottom three times. Yeah, that'll make the water disappear. Your turn, off you go. Right foot, left foot, left foot. Turn around, face the back, three knee bends, three bottom wiggles. Give her a big cheer, everybody. The water dance has made the water disappear. Do your cup feel lighter, Amanda?
No.
That's a problem. I'll go first. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Yeah! Amanda, trust the magic. I promise you, if you trust the magic and believe in the magic, you will not get wet. Slowly turn it over. Do you want me to sip it over for you? Go, Amanda. Trust the magic, Amanda. Three, two, one. That is magic. Ladies and gentlemen, big cheer for Amanda. Wow, you're amazing, Amanda. Oh, I don't feel quite so nervous now. Honestly, you made me happy today. My mum would be ashamed if she knew I was here today. She thinks I'm in prison.
We are the Dots.
The Dots.
I'm Amanda, this is Rosie, and this is Kathy.
And so where do you normally perform?
All over the place.
I've never done it before.
Oh no, we said we weren't going to do that. We weren't going to say that. Basically, yesterday, one of our original Dots actually walked out, creative differences. But Kathy has stepped in last minute.
Hang on.
She's learned the routine.
Don't just throw that away. What happened?
She's a bit difficult, should we say.
So you've never performed with them until today?
Oh.
No. Yeah. I am intrigued what you're going to do, so I'm going to let you take to the stage and go
Thank
for
you.
It.
Thank you.
I knew that was part of the act. I'm actually getting really stupid, aren't I? That was brilliant, by the way, because you really, really fooled me.
It was absolutely brilliant. Your timing was excellent. Your harmonies are actually very good. And, you know, in the end, I think you'll get there. So, good luck.
I love everything about this act. Just a genius idea. I love seeing things go wrong, and this is proper entertainment.
But you're brilliantly talented comic performers. Everyone can enjoy this, can't
they? Yeah.
You are on to something, the dot. So let me kick this off with an enormous yes.
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
I knew all along it was a joke. It's four yeses.
Come on. Here we go.
And what is your name?
My name is Brett.
Hi, Brett. And where are you from, Brett?
I'm from North Carolina.
And what do you do in North Carolina?
Twiddle my thumbs.
You're a thumb twiddler?
Yeah, a little bit. I like to entertain people, you know. I come from a musical family. My grandfather was certainly an entertainer, and my dad, he grew up wanting to be a rock star. And that's, you know, kind of why I'm here, to kind of live that dream for him.
So he didn't become a rock star?
He's a cop.
Okay. And why did you choose to come on America's Got Talent?
This is, you know, I've gone as far as I can go. And this is where it's brought me. All roads have led to this X right here. Sappy? Too sappy?
No, I like it.
Oh, okay, all right.
Well, show us what you do, and we can't wait to see it.
My name is Brett Loudermilk, and I'm a sword swallower.
Oh.
As if you didn't already know that. I need a woman from the audience to help me out. Let's see who we've got. Sophia, can I please use you?
Yeah, join me over here, Sophia.
Up the stairs. Thank you so much. Join me right over
here.
I'm not gonna swallow anything.
No, 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 you...
No, no, no.
No, wait, wait. You and I are gonna swallow a sword. I'll swallow a sword, you're gonna help, okay?
Okay.
Okay. I'm gonna place the sword into my throat and let go. I'm gonna hold it there with the muscles of my esophagus. I'll snap my fingers, open everything up. It's gonna drop down the rest of the way by itself. It's gonna bump. I'll bend myself into halves. I'll turn towards you and wink. When I wink, you grab the sword and you pull it out.
No, I'm not going to pull it!
Yes!
What if I kill you?
You were the wrong choice. Okay. Are you, you ready?
No.
Just nice and slow.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. You have to watch. You ready?
Focus, focus!
You focus, face me! All right, here we go.
No, I beg you, I can't!
What part of when I wink did you not understand?
It's winking!
We're gonna try this again,
no,
okay?
But what if I put it in?
Okay, my career has led to this. Here we go.
Look at his face, look at his face.
I don't want to.
Pull him, pull him, pull him.
Pull him.
He can't do it.
Pull out the sword.
I can't.
Just pull it out.
It's stuck there.
No, it's stuck.
It's not stuck. It's not stuck, I promise you. This is so easy. I promise. Okay, yeah. All right, last time. Okay, here we go.
Can I be honest with you? The fear was atrocious.
Well, you don't know what it felt like. When you touch it, it feels like it's stuck in there and I was going to hurt him.
Is he finished? Well, that's not his act.
I've got more. No, she...
Come on, sorry, please.
Okay, thank you.
Would you like Sophia back on stage?
Absolutely not.
May I continue?
So, I've decided to bring along this one. Now, this is what we call in the business a wiggly one. Now, because of its shape, when I swallow it, you're going to see the sword through my throat.
No, no.
Can I pull one out?
Seriously?
Yeah.
No, do
it. I really want to pull one
you
out.
You really want to pull
yeah.
one out? Let's
yeah.
do it.
Okay.
Come on.
Come on! Come on!
Wait. Wait. Howie, would you do it too?
Are you serious?
Yeah, come
serious.
On.
Serious. Would you do it too?
Well, wait, 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 wait. Let me ask something.
You need something. No. All three, all three.
Wait.
I already did it.
Come on.
Right, find your safety spot.
Somebody shout out a number. Three, perfect. All right. Good.
It just so happens that I have not one, not two, but three swords.
Three swords.
That I'm going to swallow at the same time because you asked for it.
Really?
And each one of you is going to pull out a sword. I'm jazzing right now. This was not planned.
I know. I know. I had no idea.
Have you done this before?
I haven't. No, it doesn't matter. Listen.
You're going to put all three in your mouth?
I'm going to swallow the three swords. You're going to pull out. No, actually, no, I'm sorry. You're going to pull out the last one. Okay, so it's going to be.
Are you sure about that?
Right as rain.
Will you really wink at us?
I'll wink. So I'm going to go down the line with swords in. I've never done this before.
Three at once.
Here we go.
The whole sword.
All three. Here we go.
Then we'll put
it. You start with the top.
Yeah, I got it. I got it.
Okay. Oh, three swords.
Oh, no.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Oh, my God. Concentrate.
So much. It's fun to be on TV. I hear the camera adds 10 fingers. Let's do this. People have been asking me how my life has changed since being on AGT. I'm being recognized in public a lot, which I still don't know how to feel about. Like, I'm really confident here, but out in the wild, it's a little different. I'll give you an example. After my audition aired, that following Saturday, I went to a garage sale because I party. That's how we celebrate in Indiana. And I was walking up to the sale, the guy who was running it, he saw me approaching and he went, "Cripple threat!" Which was awesome, because that means that he saw me on AGT, but no one else at the garage sale had. So it sounded like he was just warning people that a handicapped guy was approaching. Like, "You said I was crazy, but it's real! The cripple threat is here, they're among us!" He learned to pick locks, he got out of his cage! And it's hard to haggle down the price of a blender at that point, so. And I'm fist bumping a lot, everybody. I'm fist bumping just all day. I got tennis elbow from fist bumping so much, it's crazy. Like, I like to shake hands, that's what I do. Like, if you ever see me out in the street, like, I'm coming in hard and fast, just pow, let's do this. But like everyone, like nobody wants to, like everyone's fist bumping me. Like, I've been so many people's clearly first fist bump ever. I'm like, "You're 95, Ruth, all right? You don't fist bump." So I've been trying to figure out why no one wants to shake my hand, and I think I've narrowed it down to two reasons. I think number one, people don't want to shake my hand because they're afraid they're gonna like break it. Like, it's not made of crackers, everybody, all right? Like, there's bone in there. Terry Crews has shaken my hand many times and I'm fine. None of you are Terry Crews, I promise. And the second reason I think people don't want to shake my hand, and I swear this is true, I think some people are concerned they're gonna catch it. Because they're coming in just, no. And that is ridiculous, because the only way you're gonna catch it is if I sneeze in your mouth. That's the only way. And I feel a cold coming on. And I'm inspiring a lot of people, which is amazing, but I think some people are getting inspired the wrong way. I had someone come up to me after a show recently, and they were like, "Ryan, you know what? I was having a pretty rough day. Things in my life just haven't been going that great. And then I saw you. And I realized my life's not so bad anymore." If any of you thought that when you saw me walk on this stage tonight, I want you to do me a huge favor and get out, all right? You don't deserve the rest of this. That is ridiculous. Because I can't do that to anyone else. Like, I couldn't stop a woman on the street and be like, "Ma'am, you know what? I was having a pretty rough day. I just wasn't feeling like a very attractive person." "And then I saw you. And I realized I'm at least a 7. So thank you. Thank you." Before I get out of here, I'm going to end on a little bit of a sappy note. I want to thank America's Got Talent, and I want to thank all of you in America for voting me this far. It means the world to me. Thank you so much. If you could all vote for me tonight, I would really appreciate it. And if you don't vote for me, it's technically a hate crime, so. All right, I'm writing an email to you guys. Thank you all so much.
Hello.
Hi.
Good. What's your name?
Gattis Candes.
Okay, good luck.
Okay. Okay, hello. Are there any guys with big muscles in the audience? No, good, then I'll talk about them. You know, those big muscles make those guys so heavy that they cannot ride a pony. However, they can break a fragile toilet seat. I mean, do they work out to attract the ladies? Well, actually, the ladies are attracted to what's inside of a man. Back me up, ladies. If you agree, say yeah. Rapidly moving on. Public toilets, can't live without them, can't live in them either. Because there is no fridge and microwave there. Often when I use the male toilet, some guys there fart very loud, and I don't like that. So when possible, I sneak into the ladies' toilets instead, because they're much more discreet about it. Well, at least when they know that I am there. Seeing is believing, and weeing is relieving.
He's the funniest bloke we've had in Hammersmith.
More. Yes. Are you well?
Yeah.
No, you're not a well. You're a person.
What is going on here? You are the funniest, unfunniest comedian I have ever heard in my life. I mean, absolute rubbish, but it actually really, really made me laugh.
Yeah, that was my aim, to make you laugh.
Well, you certainly did that, Gattis.
It was so bad that it was actually brilliant.
Yeah. You mustn't change. You seriously must not change.
Not even the jumper. Keep the jumper.
Well, what's wrong with my jumper?
There's nothing wrong with it. It's hilarious.
I'm going to kick this off because you did actually make me laugh, and that's what comedians are supposed to do, so I'm going to say yes.
I'm going to say yes. It's a no from me today.
Oh. David?
So it rests with me. The way you must judge comedy is, did it make you laugh? Made me laugh. I'm going to say yes.
Yes. Well done. You're talking about that. Well done.
Sometimes I feel so hopeless, thinking of the things that feel so wrong in this world. My life's just a drop in the ocean. The world is my oyster, but I can't find the pearl.
Sorry. Can someone take this? This was a mistake. I'm the Parmesan cheese guy! Everyone up on your feet, let's go! So the next time you get pasta and the waiter
overflows. And if he says, say when, then you say, no! I always want more Parmesan, put on me Ferris. I always want more Parmesan, put on me Ferris. Everybody!
I always want more Parmesan, put on me Ferris.
I always want more Parmesan, put on me Ferris. Embarrassed! That is exactly how they want us to feel, so they can take all the cheese for themselves. Well, guess what, Big Parma? We're not gonna be embarrassed anymore, are we? We will not remain silent. We will not give in. We will die before we let Big Parma win. We are not embarrassed! We always want more permission! We always want more Parmesan. Answer, be ready. We always want.
We always want
more Parmesan.
More Parmesan.
We always want.
We always want
more Parmesan. The people want more. More. More Parmesan.
Hello.
How are you, David? How are you, love?
How are you?
I'm all right, thanks.
Please tell us your name.
Barbara Nice. Barbara's in Streisand, Nice is in the biscuit, Dave.
Oh. They are nice, those biscuits, aren't they?
They are, love.
And is this your day job, or...?
Well, I jig all over the country, and I just like people making fun of life and having a laugh.
Excuse me, you look familiar. Have we met?
I don't think...
OK, I was thinking... Whether you come on the show before?
No, I've never been on a competition.
This is your first time.
I've never done a competition
wow.
before.
Okay,
love.
Good for you. Yeah.
Lovely teeth, by the way. I just thought, yeah, I just thought it's about time. And if I could go to the Royal Variety performance, that's a dream come true for me.
All right, good luck.
Thanks, love. Right, so I'm going to put my bag for life down. I've got about 49 bags for life. I should never die. But who wants to live forever? Not me, I've got no proper pension. Right, I'm going to take my coat off. I can see the girls, Amanda and Alicia. Nice colour, isn't it, this Mac? It's like an apple green, girls. It's me Apple Mac, ladies and gentlemen. Hey. She's living the vida loca. Hey, come on. Diamonds are forever. Keep your eye on it, love. You look like you keep a good house. So, $4.99. I like a bargain, like I see a lot of you do. So this frock, forget DKNY. This frock was CPL, Cats Protection League. If my husband Ken could see me now, you know, here, auditioning BGT, he'd go mad. He thinks I'm dog sitting for Jean and Jean in Ebden Bridge, so keep it. Mum's the word. You're friendly. That's what I like. I bumped into a very, very good old friend of mine, Unlucky Mary. Come in here. She said, Barbara, I'm in trouble with police. I thought, what's new? I said, well, what's been going on? She said, I've been caught speeding while knitting. I know. Apparently, the police said, pull over. She said, no, cardigan. We're living a vida loca. We've got to have a laugh, kids. It's all we've got left.
I love her.
I love her.
And this has cheered me up, this has. I was outside having a bit of fresh air, and I got a text. I'm very sorry, Barbara. Your boiler's broken down. It's awful news, isn't it? And I thought, I'm not going doing that audition. I've got to get the bus, go back home, cos Ken will go to pieces. It's a crisis. But, you know, in life, do you ever think there's signs?
Yes.
Yeah, right, smashing. There are signs in life. And I looked up at this tree and there was a white carrier bag caught in the branches. And I looked up and I thought, that's 5p up there, Barbara. And then suddenly, there was a gust of wind and that carrier bag blew high up, free as a bird, and I thought, forget about the pig in boiler bag. Let it go. That's the cue for the stage dive. So those lads, come down here. Give them a round of applause. I met them in the queue. Down here, kids.
Thank you so much. Hello, everybody. So, Paralympics just finished up, and I'm happy to say that I was a member of the U.S. Paralympic soccer team, and I was a... thank you. Wow. Where were you guys at the games? Could have used those 18 claps. All right, no. Little late, guys, little late. I know some of you maybe don't know what the Paralympics are. It's the Olympics for people with physical disabilities. It's the second largest sporting event on the planet. Second only... hey, guys, I only got 2 minutes, so please shut up. The second largest sporting event only to the able-bodied Olympics. Yeah, it must be tough running with two legs, huh? All right. Thank you. Again, I appreciate it, but please. does anyone know how we did in the Paralympics? Again, thank you for your support. let's just say me and my teammates didn't have to worry about getting tested for any performance-enhancing drugs. I remember I played against the Russian team. I was but a spectator on the field. Just watching other players. Okay, well, there's nothing even wrong with that guy right there. You better get a neurologist out here. I got injured in one of the games, and my coach had the nerve to put me on the disabled list. Come on. One thing I miss about being on the team is traveling with everybody, because to me, there's nothing more entertaining than watching 12 dudes with cerebral palsy get off an airplane in a row. Everybody in the terminal thinks there's some type of zombie invasion going on. He's the goalie. Yeah. None of us really walk like that. We just like messing around. One thing I don't miss about being on the team is our coach used to make us dress alike, which is great, representing your great, beautiful country. But we're already a bunch of crippled dudes trying not to stick out as it is. Now you got us all wearing the same goofy-ass tracksuit. All I'm saying, coach, is just give us a chance. People walking by us like, oh, that's nice. They took them to the mall. Yeah. Some of them got stuff. So naughty, huh, Simon? Hey, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much.
This is the story about love. When a guy meets a girl in a bar, he sees the girl, he looks at her, and all he wants to say is a great big
hello. Is it me you're looking for?
She looked lovely. The dress that night she was wearing was
gold.
She wasn't looking at him, so he showed her his best dance moves.
What does the fox say? What the fox say?
Every day I'm shuffling.
Hey, you look thirsty. You want a drink? What you want?
Tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Why?
It makes me happy.
Fair enough. The girl looks at the guy and says, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the toilet. Don't go, he says. Please don't go.
Please don't go.
I love this act.
The girl comes back.
I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it.
The girl laughs at the guy and says, hey, wanna come back to my place for a coffee? The guy says, hey.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the guy got with the girl and now they've been together for 45 years.
If I could turn back time.
And that is the fairy tale of love.
Thank you for watching.
Oh, Simon loves clowns.
Simon.
You love clowns?
He loves clowns.
Yeah. This is going to be fun. Good evening. How are you?
Hola, muy bien, gracias a usted.
Ah, habla español.
Sí, claro.
What is your name? Nombre?
Me llamo Papayazo.
Papayazo.
Sí, Papayazo.
Where are you from? ¿De dónde eres?
De Chile.
Ah, from Chile. What are you going to do for us tonight, Papayazo?
Hoy día voy a hacer imitaciones.
Impressions.
Sí.
Okay, let's see what you've got tonight.
Okay. Primero, yo soy un elefante. ¿No? Okay. Quizás un perrito. Ruf, ruf.
No.
Is that supposed to be a dog? Okay, entonces, yo soy el Jason Statham.
I got one last job for ya. And this time, it ain't gonna be easy.
That's perfect.
Okay, ustedes les quitan personas famosas, entonces aquí hay otra. Este es el David Attenborough.
The Chilean clown is known for surviving solely off laughter. Therefore, this clown is in mortal danger.
No, está bien. Okay, otra para ustedes. Este es el Jimmy Fallon. Great show night, everybody. We got Adam Driver in the house. Now, Adam Driver, I've been meaning to ask you, man, like, what's going on?
What's going on, Jimmy, is that I'm an incredibly gifted actor. And if you do not agree with that, then you do not know what I am capable of!
Whoa! Adam Driver, ¿no es cierto? Okay. Tengo una más para ustedes. Esta es la última, last one. Este es el Simon Cowell.
I don't mean to be rude, but
I've seen funnier clowns in horror films.
Oh, yes! Yes!
Amazing! I'm surprised. I thought you were gonna come and, you know, clown around. I'm gonna be honest, this was very big surprise. Good for you.
We look for moments and we look for surprises. And you are a moment and you are a surprise. The way you started out with the animal noises, we thought, oh, this is a joke act. And then you are one of the best impressionists I've ever heard.
I thought your impressions were amazing. What I even loved most is how excited you were when it worked out in the end. You did your impression and then you were so happy with yourself when you were laughing, that made me laugh.
seriously. I don't know what to say. I've never seen or met a funny clown in the world. You might be the only one.
Muchas gracias.
Bueno, vamos a votar. We're going to vote for
okay,
you.
Okay.
I'm going to give you the first yes.
Simon.
Two yeses.
Ali.
Second.
Four yeses.
Hello.
Who are you?
My name is Josh.
Josh.
Both.
Both?
Both.
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 Where's yeah. that from?
As you can tell from the accent, it's Scandinavian.
Yeah. Excellent.
Proper. Scandi.
Excellent.
Viking.
Yeah. Where are you from?
I am from London.
OK, brilliant. Good yeah. luck.
All right, cool. Do I go now?
Yeah, just yeah. do it.
All right, cool. So I moved in with my girlfriend recently, right? Now, like, things have changed with my girlfriend, right? No one warned me that my girlfriend was going to get addicted to Groupon, right? My girlfriend loves Groupon. She's addicted to the discount websites. That's the only reason I'm here, is to get rich. Because I can't deal with the phone calls. When she rings me up at work, she's like, babe, take tomorrow off. We're going alpaca trekking Swansea. £8 each. It's always the most random stuff, right? I wake up middle of an iPad lighting up her face. And I see you're finally awake. Thinking trampoline in Skegness. Complimentary glass of champagne, free foot massage, £3.50. Like, it makes no sense, right? I'm worried next year it'll be like a Louis Theroux documentary. The dark side of Groupon. Both homeless. I'm just sat there like, Louie, it's gotten out of hand, mate. Been doing 4 spa packages a day. I'm clinically addicted to whale music. My girlfriend sat next to me, bald from head to toe. I mean, it was 90% off laser hair removal. I mean, it's too good a deal to be missed. Louis comes over the voiceover. Unfortunately, Joshua and Harriet died by the end of filming. Skydiving in Luton for a fiver. Thought the parachute was complimentary, it wasn't. It's a glass of Prosecco. My girlfriend loves a glass of Prosecco, right? And she always gets 2 types of drunk, right? First type of drunk, she's loving life, right? She's singing, she's dancing, she's got an Aperol spritz.
Yes.
Because that's what she drinks now.
Yes.
She always dances like this. She's like, one kiss is all it takes. Fall in love with me. Possibilities. One kiss is all it takes. Fall in love with me. She starts doing this head thing she learned from Mystique, right? She's like, one kiss is all it takes.
That's you on a night out. That's you.
Fall in love with me. There's no music playing, we're in a smoking area. But about an hour later, right, she goes 2 words, right? She gets reduced to 2 words. I turn to her, I go, is everything all right, babe? And she goes, chicken nuggets.
His timing brilliant.
He's funny, man.
And her friends are the same, right? There's always that one friend, like, mascara down her face, high heels in hand, just ready to go home. She's like, chicken nuggets. There's the friend kissing the guy, chicken nuggets. There's a vegetarian, I'll have chips. And chicken nuggets. I'll be Josh Bob. Thank you.
Wow, you are fantastically funny. You're super confident. So I think you've got all the things you need to go all the way to the very top. So I thank you for coming on this show tonight. You were fantastic.
Thank you. I'll say that.
Yeah, I really like you. I liked you from your opening chat. I like that you made it very personal about your missus. I loved all of that. I thought the whole act was great. Really natural.
I'll say that. Thank you.
Yeah, there's something kind of unique about you. I think people will, they'll like you, apart from the fact that you're funny.
Oh, that's good.
And that was a good audition.
Thank you.
We always talk about people being funny or having funny bones, and you're naturally very funny. I'm going to say yes.
I'm saying yes.
All right, good.
I'm going to say yes.
Well, then you've got four yeses. Yes.
Hey, well done.
Thank you.
People often think my disability defines my existence. They say something like, oh, you have cerebral palsy. I know another guy with cerebral palsy. You should be best friends. But they don't like it when I go up and say, oh, you're an idiot. Know someone else who's an idiot. You should be best friends. And you don't get that with any other medical conditions either. I've never heard someone say, oh, you have herpes. My brother has herpes. You should be best friends. I have cerebral palsy. CP does not affect intelligence or hearing. In fact, the most interesting symptom of cerebral palsy is how it makes other people freaking stupid. For example, people come up to me and start gesturing at me, yelling real slow like, hello, can I pet your doggy? And I'm like, oh my, are you okay? Are you having a stroke? Do you need me to call 911? Oh, you're just an idiot. I guess we don't need an ambulance for that. People always ask why I need a service dog. I don't. You got me, I'm faking it. He has two primary services. First, he gets my beer for me. Good boy. Now, number two, fetch me a girlfriend. You're ruining my set, you jerk. Go fetch Sophia Viagra.
I'm here. I'm single.
Oh no. Damn autocorrect. I meant Sophia Vergara. We're almost done. But remember, if you don't vote for me, he won't eat tonight. I'm just kidding. Of course, he'll eat tonight. He's the one that makes us dinner. Okay, make funny jokes, check. Hit on Sophia, check. Brought dog out for bonus votes, check. Perfect. That's my time. Love you all.
Aaron Belay!
Heidi!
I love how you figured out your dream to become a comedian, and it's beautiful to see you up there being so happy and making all of us laugh. Thank you so much for being here.
Sophia!
Well, I think this, I love the way you look at life. I love that that's what makes you so funny, that you make fun of yourself, that you're like so like happy with yourself. And
has anyone ever called you Sophia?
No, they have called me like that before.
Viagra?
But I'm single.
Simon! No.
Well, you are naturally funny. I mean, just that. I mean, if you're a comedian, that's what it's all about. And interestingly, unlike other acts tonight, I actually wanted it to go on longer. And you know, one of my favorite bits was when the dog, even the dog's face when he was looking at you, even the dog's funny. He was just giving you this look like, yeah, yeah, yeah. But that was good.
Bravo!
Howie, you are on your feet.
Yeah, I'm on my feet because I love this guy. I agree with Sophia. If anybody deserves to go on and voted for one of the two, it is you. Your timing is great. Your personality is great. And I've been a fan of yours since you were first here. I love when you work dirty. We can't see it here, but you're brilliant.
Now, Aaron, why should America vote for you?
Well, I'm competing with 65 hand dancers and a rock band, and I'm equipped with nothing but a phone and a thumb.
So, Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son, he's in the audience.
Nice.
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
We're friends now.
Yeah, okay, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job. This is obviously what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%. 100% it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going. Yeah. So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was gonna drive here today. I realized I don't have a license, so. Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? Think, no, you don't. This old lady's strong, oh my. Have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Woo! Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a -2 at King's Cross, love. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. But on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we wanted to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good.
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it. Beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiance have been together for years, 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 years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humor. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's the trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know when you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at a decent time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face, get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face, but how do I do it? In style.
Yay! In style!
My name's Axel Blake, thank you.
What did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that stage. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You got a wonderful, so likable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this.
My name is Vicky Barbalak.
What are you going to be doing for us today?
I'm a ballerina.
Ballerina.
No, I can't be a ballerina because I want dinner. I'm a comedian.
You're a comedian. You know, comedy, I think, is one of the hardest things to do because you have to entertain a whole entire room and make us all laugh.
Is that what's going on here?
Shoot. I can't wait to see this. Good luck.
All right. Thank you.
Heidi, you're looking at me like you never saw a trophy wife in Los Angeles before. I'm sorry. I gotta say, yesterday I had a lot of nervous energy and I decided I'd go out to Donnelly Men's Prison for a conjugal visit. And it was like raining, three drops of rain. You know, in San Diego, that's like a blizzard. So it took like 3 hours to get out to Donnelly for the conjugal visit. And I'm not kidding you, I drive all the way out there and it turns out at Donnelly, you have to know somebody. Is that horrible? It's ridiculous. I hated that. Some things just don't make sense to me, like that Elon Musk guy. He could put a rocket up in the sky, you know, and it comes back down to Earth, lands on a paper cup, right? But nobody, nobody can design a bra that doesn't feel like recycled shrapnel. What's up? Right, Heidi, get on that.
I can.
Please. I'm gonna try one of yours. I need a bra, it's necessary, right? I take my bra off, my boobs fall down like a broken mini blind. I'm sitting dragging. I mean it. This is all being taken care of. This is all, I'm in therapy. We're good. You know, it's like, it's status symbol today. Like, I'm in therapy. I'm really good insurance. There's actually a court order for me, okay? So, I'm not lying. And you have to be really careful with therapists, like it's their only job to find things wrong with you, right? This woman, she's like, so, Vicky, do you ever drink alone? No way, only alcoholics drink alone, right? I read all those pamphlets in your office, man. No, I always wait till the kids get home from school, right? Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Oh, my goodness. Hello.
Hello, Alicia.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiance. We've got a little boy called Roman who's here as well.
And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. Okay, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Coach! Rooting for this. I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I am a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, Kujo, come here. Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? The coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered, he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. Dad! Can't you get it yourself? It was 1 p.m, but it got dark real quick. The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes, I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows, 4! But there's only 1 person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long, go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones, yeah? So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you, right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open. I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence. I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met. He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy. Like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride, you can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently, me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter. The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5. Very good. My name is Kojo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Kojo, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Man.
I'm so happy right now.
I've always respected you. My respect level for you's just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny. Yeah. You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. But I love you.
Thank you.
I really get it.
I
have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you. Enjoy this.
Let's get a bit of atmosphere. I'm not messing about it. Three of them straight away. Hey, 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 That's the first gag! I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll do a bit of balloon modelling. Alicia, can I ask you to name an animal? Give me a challenge. Go on, give me a challenge. Any animal.
Elephant.
I'm sorry. It's a lovely
Any other animal. I'll tell you what I'll do. I've seen this done on Britain's Got Talent before, this mind reading stuff. And I'm into that Derren Brown. He simply puts ideas into people's heads without them realising it. I'm going to make you think of a very specific animal now, Alicia. When you get a clear image of the animal that I'm sending to your brain, shout out the name of the animal so everyone can hear loud and clear, and woof, I'll make it as fast as that. So when you get a clear image of the animal, woof, woof, that's how fast. What? Just
dog,
say dog.
Dog,
I've only got 4 minutes.
Dog,
nine, four.
Dog.
Balloon animal, no. Hardest part of this is blowing the balloon up.
Look at his cheeks.
Get it. I'll do something else. Enjoy now the beautiful sound of the Spanish guitar. I've just got to get the guitar, which is situated just over here. Footwork.
Para Ciro no volverá más. Y me hizo volar en el cielo infinito.
And where are you from?
My name is Maureen Langan. I live in Manhattan, but I grew up in Lake Hiawatha, New Jersey, where there is no lake.
So what is your talent? What will you be doing for us today?
I am a stand-up comedian.
What got you into comedy?
Well, I say a gift from God, but really, it's you grow up in a big Irish Catholic family with 5 siblings. You're always taking the crap out of each other, and it's just part of a natural wit, I think. You'll see.
Okay, the stage is yours. Have fun.
Thank you.
And hopefully we have some fun with you.
I don't want to hate people. They make me hate them. I'm all about love. You feel that immediately with me. But I was on the airplane coming here. A woman in the seat behind me, she gets up and she starts spritzing cinnamon. I go, lady, what are you doing? She goes, well, it's natural. I go, so's my butt, but I'm not putting it in your face. I didn't want to hate her. She made me hate her. Do you see what's happening there?
Yes.
I'm a victim. I had a car accident recently. I'm all right, don't worry. Young guy, stoned out of his mind, on his cell phone, music blaring, looked a lot like you. Gets out of his car, you know, with the man bun. Dude, I don't know what happened, dude. I'm like, oh, what happened is in 1999, your mother forgot her birth control. That's what happened, dude. Well, wait a minute. I didn't want say that. He made me say it. I was a victim. I was victimized. Okay, so what, truth be told, I am at that age, post-period, pre-death. That's my age range. Here it is. I don't want to be a cougar. Absolutely not. I don't need some young hot guy named Chad touching my belly fat going, ooh, what's this? What's this? This is rage. Rage. Covered by affordable treats and wine from Trader Joe's. That's what this is. We got going here, baby. Yeah. Yes. Yes. You know what I want? This is what I want. I want a guy around 86 years old where I am the hottest thing between him and death. He can't believe he got me because he knows he'll never get anyone better to the day he dies. And he's not looking over his shoulder for somebody younger and hotter. You know why? He has arthritis in his neck. He can't move his neck. And he sees none of my flaws. He sees no cellulite, belly fat, varicose veins. Why? Cataracts. Cataracts. And you know what? Let me tell you something. I love him. And I look into his milky white eyes. And I say, I love you! Because he's hard of hearing and I want him to know. Because I'm all about love. Thanks, you guys. I'm Maureen Langan. Thank you. Oh, God. Thank you.
Jersey, 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 Jersey.
Thank you. That means a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
You're funny, Maureen. It's the timing. You just have this really good timing
in
your voice and how you just like bam, 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 bam. You just have the next one coming and the next one coming. I mean, I was laughing a lot. So were you. So were you.
Yeah, well, everybody was.
Were you laughing, Simon?
So funny, so fearless. That's what Simon says.
Thank you.
What about you, Sophia?
It was fascinating. Your energy, the way that you control the stage, you didn't miss one beat. You know your material.
She had like the body movement.
She was so tough.
Yeah. You feel like you need to be like on a TV show, actually.
Thank you.
Yes. You know, you have a voice where we can hear you and we can hear your rhythm and we can hear your attitude and we love it and we connect with it. I think people not only gonna love you, they will imitate you, they'll want to see you. You have catchphrases. Yes. You have everything in that arsenal that a great comedian needs. You are ready to explode.
Thank you.
I wanted to love you, and I did love you.
Hello, London.
Hello. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, nice tea cup. I like tea.
I love tea.
I love tea.
I love tea.
Yeah.
What is your name and where have you come from?
I'm Tony Kaku.
Where are you from, Tony?
Japan.
Oh, I love Japan.
Yeah, Tony Kaku, Japan.
Why have you flown all the way to be on Britain's Got Talent?
I want to perform to loyal family. King Charles loved me.
And what you're doing for us today, is it your day job?
Yes.
Yeah?
If you want it to be, it is.
Do you want to just get on with it?
Okay.
Yeah.
My dance never seen before.
Oh, no, 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 no.
He's gonna take it off.
I'm wearing pants.
Yes.
But I can pose naked.
Oh, okay? No, thank you.
Number one, football player naked pose.
Ha ha!
I'm wearing.
Pants!
Okay. Okay. Number two. Okay. Horse racer naked pole. Number three, James Bond, naked pole.
James Bond, yeah.
Come on.
Come on.
I love it so much.
Don't worry, I'm wearing. Finally!
Don't stop!
Spice Girls!
Spice Girls!
Wannabe!
Wannabe!
Naked pose! Come on!
Come on!
Okay, okay.
Tony, you might actually be my favorite contestant of the whole series so far.
Thank you. Arigato gozaimasu.
No, arigato gozaimasu to you.
Yeah, thank you. Oh my God.
Come on, Tony. Bruno, what did you
listen,
think?
Listen, I have to say, you definitely have balls. Great. What can
thank
I say?
Thank you.
Nanda,
Tony, you are absolutely unique. And it felt very Britain's Got Talent. I loved it.
Thank you.
Simon?
Honestly, you are the funniest contestant we've had on all year. Seriously.
Funny boy!
Really, really funny and original.
Thank you. Simon naked pose?
No.
Simon?
No. Always keep them waiting, Tony.
We're gonna have to take a vote now, though.
Oh, it's a yes from me.
Yes.
Amanda.
It's a yes from me, Tony.
Thank you.
Tony Kaku.
Tony Kaku.
It's a yes from me.
Really?
Yes. Simon.
Tony, honestly, you are unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
You are brilliant.
Simon, love me.
I absolutely love you.
Unbelievable.
You have four yeses. You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
And what's your name?
My name is Daliso. Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh, yes!
Comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother... No, he wanted to come. He's a doctor. And he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming. So uh-huh. I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown.
So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now. All my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you're so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says, thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say, thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one Save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummy? Thank you so much, Brummy.
I mean, laugh after laugh after laugh. It just kept on coming. And I really want you to win the entire series!
Thank you so much.
I think you could. And I think you have a golden future.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm shocked and delighted.
So am I.
My face is hurting from laughing. I'm so pleased that Amanda pressed her golden buzzer for you. You are brilliant, and I cannot wait to hear more from you. Well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
You should.
should be a comedy superstar.
Yes.
All the jokes were really original, and you are incredibly likable. I couldn't fault it. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well, not only do I think you're an undiscovered little star, I could see you owning your own show.
Thank you.
What you did was so funny and naughty and unique. This is why we make shows like this, to find people like you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Come on!
Ichikawa, congratulations.
Thank you.
There's no other place for you, really, than this show.
I can assure you one thing. It's not fake. It's real.
I am literally speechless. It's like an out-of-body experience.
Listen, one series on this show, that will become normal.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe that I enjoyed that. I actually really enjoyed it.
What I'm most looking forward to is potentially saying, Your Royal Highness King Charles, may we proudly present the winner of Britain's Got Talent. We're going to take a vote, Ichikawa. It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Alicia.
I enjoyed that, but I don't ever want to see it again.
What?
You want to see it again?
Yeah!
Okay, for the potential, it's a yes.
Thank you!
Bruno.
Oh, it's a no for me. but it's a no. I mean, here we go.
Simon.
Well, I didn't know what was going on. I genuinely hadn't got a clue. And then I understood. I remember watching Rocky for the first time, thinking one of the most suspenseful, exciting end of a movie I've ever seen. And that was up there. I've never wanted a balloon to burst so much in my life. Take that buzzer away. By the wind beneath my wings. I am thrilled to give you your third yes. Did I
ever tell you your mind here
on? Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Thank you, I'm excited to be here.
What's your name and how old are you?
My name is Harrison Greenbaum, I'm 30 years old.
What is it you're going to be doing for us today?
I'm a stand-up comedian. Yes.
So how long have you been doing stand-up comedy?
Well, I've been doing about 600-700 shows a year every year for the last 12 years.
That's wow. More than what you do.
Way more than me.
3 or 4 a night every night in New York.
You do all those gigs 10, 12 years.
Yeah.
So what is the tipping point that takes you from doing that into wherever the next level is you want to be?
I mean, hopefully this, right? I mean, I'm doing shows in pizzerias and basements and having beer bottles thrown on my head. So this is very nice. I mean, I've been putting the work in, but this is the big moment. This is the make or break, for sure.
The stage is yours, Harrison.
Thank you. Yeah, so I decided to be a comedian senior year of college. That's when I had to tell my parents who were paying for college. Like, I had to sit them down. I was like, Mom, Dad, I have something very difficult to tell you. And they were like, you're gay. I was like, no, I want to be a comedian. And they were like, we'd rather you be gay. Like, is that still an option on the table? Because we'll go to the parade. We will go. I get it. People think I'm gay because every single thing about me. It's weird when you're not gay, but people think you're gay. People will argue with you about you, right? Like, you know what I'm talking about. Like, right? Same boat, right? They don't do that with their other preferences. I've never been at a deli. They're just like, hey, do you want cucumber? I'm like, nah. They're like, you want cucumber. You look and sound like you love cucumber. No, I don't. We're gonna put it on your sandwich. You're lying to yourself. All right, that's it for me. Thank you so much,
no,
everybody. Thank you.
I don't need to stop.
Thank you.
I
love it.
What's your name?
My name's Zipra Tafari.
Okay. And how old are you?
Zipra Tafari is 49.
Right.
Lots of fruit, diet, and water.
So how old do you think you look? Because I thought you were about 51.
Zippy, I agree with David. I thought you were older.
Si, I've got to respect you to the max. I'm not going to start with you.
He loves being called Si. He loves it.
Well, I'm just saying, what I'm trying to say now, Simon, you look great. You do look great.
Yeah, he's had quite a lot of work
done. The panel looks great itself.
And where do you see yourself going? Because we obviously don't know what you're going to do yet.
What I'm about to rap about is losing...
Rapping, you've given it away.
Yes, yeah. Sir. Yes, sir. A rap song about losing your keys and your phone. A lot of people have lost the keys and phone.
He loses keys at my house a lot, don't
he? I do that, yeah.
And then he walks home, get a phone call. I've left my keys at yours, haven't I?
Got to come back.
Well, this song would affect everyone, even Prince Charles.
Yes. I don't think he really needs keys to get into Buckingham Palace. I think...
Well, the other day, he telephoned me and says, where's my bloody keys? You know what? Let's get on with it.
My thoughts exactly. Yeah.
Well, girl, I tell you no. You're hiding me things here. Find me keys, no. Now humbug me here. You hear me now? Yeah, girl. Where my keys? I wear my phone. I wear my keys. I wear my phone. I wear my keys. I wear my phone. I wear my keys. Have you ever been in this situation where you lost your keys and your mobile? Have you ever been in that situation where you lost your keys and your mobile? Have you ever been in that situation where you lost your keys and your mobile? Have you ever been in that situation where you lost your keys and your mobile? Hands in your front, in your back pocket, moving things like you're demented. Can't remember where you put it. Hot, cold, frustrated. I wear my keys, I wear my phone. I wear my keys, I wear my phone.
I wear my keys, I wear my phone.
Yo, Alicia, give me a ring. I can't hear a thing.
Alicia Dixon, your thoughts?
Have you ever been in that situation where you lost your keys or you lost your phone? Have you ever been? I wear my keys. I wear my phone. Oh, I loved it. Oh, that was genius.
Amanda Holden.
Yeah, it's really easy to remember.
Yes!
I loved it. Even you were doing jiggy jiggy to it.
No, it was catchy.
Zippy.
No, Zipra.
No, I know, but Zippy works better. Because...
OK.
When you started, I thought you're annoying. Then you got more annoying. And then I liked you.
That's right. Every time when you lose your keys, you're not smiling. Oh, yeah, where's my keys? Oh, yeah. No, you are, Simon, angry. Oh, where my keys? Where is it?
Let's have a vote.
Zipra, you've been the highlight of my day so far. It's a yes from me.
No brainer. Yes.
Yes for me.
I don't know where this is going to go, Zippy.
Probably straight to number one.
I can't get the song out of my head. I'm gonna say yes. Hi, and you are
Mr. Methane. I am a performing flatulist. And
just do it.
Okay, certainly. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to put the art into fart. First of all, I just have to adopt the farting position. OK. You pick...
Who's that?
That was a good one.
Music Master! Thank you. Thank you.
I'm not using that microphone after him.
Thanks.
You are a disgusting creature. Where are you from?
I'm from South Norfolk.
What's your day job, Ben?
I do this act.
OK, I'm not going to ask what it is because we like surprises.
Lush.
Tell me why you've entered the show this year.
Well, my two little boys, they say, come on, Daddy, you've got to be on Britain's Got Talent.
So you've got sons, you've got kids?
I've got two children.
OK, anything else?
Yeah, well, they did have a cat. Yeah.
Yeah. I won't go there. All right, Ben, good luck.
Thank you ever so much. Well, you see, I think my little stint now is all about me mishearing lyrics in music, see? I mean, it all started when I went to see The Lion King. Anybody see The Lion King? Yeah. Oh, I love The Lion King, but I must have misheard something, right? Because I thought the first song was about the Arsenal club football manager.
That's funny.
What I did then, right, I had a little think to myself. I thought, oh, maybe there's other songs, right, that you can hear that you think maybe they're singing something different, right? So I've amalgamated loads, and it's just for you. Hit it, Shirley! Come on, come on.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I've been very well looked after.
Oh, that's good.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay. And what's your name?
My name is Johnny Awesome.
Come on, Johnny.
Be awesome.
I'm 39. I'm from Derby, but I live in Croydon.
Okay. And are you married?
Yeah, I'm married and I've got two small children.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a full-time comedian, yeah.
So tell me, Johnny, what's missing? What has been missing?
I wanted to come and play on a big stage to a theatre full of people, and I'm here, and I'm very excited about doing it.
What is that break you need?
Well, I'll be totally honest. I need the chance to play to a big audience.
Yeah.
Such as Britain's Got Talent.
OK. I'm really hoping this is going to go well, Johnny.
Thank you. Actually, just before I start, Ant and Dex, still there? Can you just pop out here for 1 second? Sorry. Ant, I'll just put you there. Just stand next to me. And Dex, if you just go there.
Yeah, sure.
I know this is crazy, but I just want to see if you can do something, right? You stay stood there. When I go down, guys, you stay there.
Yeah.
When I come back up again, I want to see if you guys can go down. So look, here we go.
Right.
I'm going down, and then I'm coming back up, and you're going down. Can we get a rhythm going? Is there a rhythm to that? Is there any rhythm? Oh, look at them go. Look at them go. Yes.
I like this.
Let me just ask you one quick question. Have you boys ever been to see a musical in the West End?
Yeah, yeah.
Which one did you see?
Oh, I've seen loads. Wicked.
Wicked? Yeah, yeah, it's a good one. What makes me laugh, though, is that when you go and see a musical, some guy will just start belting out a song.
Start belting out a song.
Apparently, it's not unusual. In fact, the band will start to play along, and then the music swells up, and the lights will change. God, it's not Chicago or we'd be in our pants. This is a musical, we're the talk of the town. Our choreographer has made us bob up and down. This is a musical featuring and deck. Oh, boys, when you're starring in a musical, it's important that you can sing. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But guys, that ain't the only thing. No, no. You've got to dress up right. That's for the opening night. And with a costume, you'll feel like a king. Looking good, this is a musical. And we're wearing our hats. Because this is a musical, we don't look like rats.
This is a
musical featuring pants and deck. Now, audience, double claps, come on. Oh, look, even Simon Cowell is doing it. That's great. And, oh, God, boys, yes. Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, my God, put your arms around me. I think we're about to be part of a chorus line. Let's go that way.
This is everything.
This is a musical, and we're changing the key. I don't know why we did that now. It's too high for me. We'll do whatever our director commands. We're all grinning like idiots. We're doing jazz hands. This is a musical.
Well done. Well done.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Orson.
Everything about it was really, really polished. The lyrics were brilliant, and you are the most likeable guy.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Johnny, that was brilliantly inventive. The amount of people we give, you know, 2 or 3 minutes on the show to, and, you know, you think, wow, is that it? Well, you went to town. I mean, we couldn't want for anything more.
Thank you very much. Oh, well, thank you. Appreciate it.
You did a full-scale show for us. And you featured Anton Deck, OBE.
Yes from us.
Yes from me.
It was absolutely brilliant.
Thank you.
Johnny, it was so smart. I think this whole kind of musical thing, singing, it really works because it makes you stand out.
Thank you, Simon.
I like you a lot. We're going to vote. David?
Well, obviously, I'm going to say yes!
Thank you, David.
I'm saying yes.
Thank you very much.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Johnny Awesome, you deserve, and you've got, 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
Oh! Well, I remember this guy before.
Woo!
He's always funny.
I love you.
What's
I
up?
Love this guy.
How you doing?
Preacher Lawson.
Hey, what's up, Howard Mendel?
Are you happy that he picked you?
I am so. I feel like it's a golden opportunity. Well, it could have been a golden opportunity.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I can't believe.
Actually,
I'm a comedian, Howie.
Yes.
Howie, you did know that Preacher was coming on tonight, right? But you gave your golden buzzer to another act.
In the moment, I got caught up in emotion.
To be fair, they look like me with my shirt off, so that's... Every time I've been on America's Got Talent, I've been losing, and this time I'm here to take over, okay?
That's what I want.
Showed him the laugh.
All right. What's up, y'all? Good to be back on America's Got Talent. This is great, man. Changed my life. Got the tour everywhere. Got the tour. I was in England. In England! Sorry, that was weird. I'm sorry. England! I like doing that. I know. I know it's bad. I like doing it, though. England! But it's bad. But, like, you know who else does really bad impressions? English people when they do American accents. It's bad, too. They always do the same accent. I'm from America! Every time. They do that one, or they do, like, I'm American, right? Or the third one is, yo, 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 my man. I'm like, I wonder what race he is. You know, they just assume all black people in America sound like DMX for some reason. America in the building, where my dogs? I gotta pee, all right? I don't know how to transition. I'm just letting you know I gotta pee. You ever have to pee like real bad, like, you know, real bad? You at a public restroom, right? Right? And instead of it saying like men or women, they try to be creative. It's like a boat and a fish. You like, which one? Everyone's walking to the wrong restroom. Every woman in here has walked in and been like, when they put urine on inside the restroom? And every dude has walked in like, is that a couch? They got a couch? Is that a vending machine? What kind of candy is that? That's some weird candy. They got lotion? Why they got lotion inside the restroom? Can't have lotion in the men's restroom.
Oh! Oh!
Yeah. You know, because we're not going to use it. It's a waste of lotion. What are y'all laughing at? What were y'all laughing at? It's funny because women are cleaner than men until it comes to your restroom. I went into a woman's restroom, I seen pee on the toilet. Like, I expect that in a men's restroom. Fellas, how many times you walked in the restroom and you seen pee on the ground immediately? Right? Who's that guy walking in? Oh, man, I was so close. There's always some old dude peeing 3 feet from the toilet. It's like, come on, man. We all know you don't got that much horsepower. But women are funny. Women are the only people that go to the restroom in groups. You rarely see dudes. I got to pee, Brandon. Let's roll, brother. Should say something. Let's get out of here, man. Where's Tyler at? Tyler here? Yeah. All three of us, we can go together, you know. Hopefully they got a couch. You know, we can take selfies. That'd be awesome. That'd be nice. Is that lotion? My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. Y'all are awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, my God. Danny O. You got jokes. You got charisma. I don't have a golden buzzer anymore.
You don't!
But I got a feeling you're not going to need it. I got a feeling that you're going to be one of the six that go through today.
Thank you.
I feel like this was the funniest set ever. Not even just from you, from anyone ever doing a set.
Oh, you better stop, girl. You what?
The only way you can judge this is, did we laugh more? And the answer is yes.
Yes!
That is what I would call a winning performance. And I really like you.
Yes, we love you.
Howie's my hype man. I appreciate that.
I love you, buddy.
I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant. That was so good. You were so good.
We would start this evening by creating a brand new business here live tonight with you guys. It could be badminton lessons. What sort of business do you want to see?
Sells Wellington boots.
Sells Wellington boots, David? Of course it sells Wellington boots. But we're going to get a very specific type or group of person to make our Wellington boots. It could be firemen or ballerinas. Who's going to be doing it? Judges?
Air hostesses.
Air hostesses. Of course it's going to be air hostesses. And this one is a question for the audience in the room. What I would love is a celebrity who is going to be in charge of our business. Any celebrity at all. Shout them out, audience. And I'm dead. Guys, we've got a new business for you. So, from you, could we please get a big old round of applause as we hit the music and take it away?
Guys, I've got an idea.
What's that, Tom?
Your brains, it's going to hurt.
Okay.
It's a brand new business. We'll make boots for stomping through the dirt.
I like it.
But it's so much more than that, friends. People ask us why. It's air hostesses making them at least a mile high.
Tom, I like this idea. Yes, you know we're all in cahoots. Yeah. If David was making them, then they would be called Wellington boots. And yes, my friend, these will be perfect. Stitch and to stitch, we've got Ant and Deck there in charge. I'm still not sure which one is which.
Which one's the one with the forehead?
They've both got foreheads.
That is true.
It's true.
They do both have foreheads.
What are we going to call the business, man?
Simple name for it. Ant and Deck Swellies.
Yeah!
Jungle Ant and Deck Squellies. Yeah, but they are always ready to rumble.
Good times.
Oh, guys,
on your feet.
So sorry. Oh, friends, you need to know.
Flying high.
My feet.
With the boys.
So dry.
We'll start it in Biker Grove.
Ant and Deck Squellies. Yeah, they might need them in the jungle.
Ant and Deck Squellies.
idea. This is a good idea.
They are always ready to rumble. You need Ant and Dex Wellies, and they're ready to rumble.
There we go. There we go.
Come on.